Hot potato, hot potato.
The Wiggles' iconic hot potato.
Hot potato, hot potato.
Blasted through loudspeakers on loop 24/7 at this venue in the coastal city of Bunbury, WA, where the homeless also take shelter.
Hot potato, hot potato.
Why? To drive homeless people away.
Playing loud music and to try and move people on is just not the way to end homelessness.
The Wiggles have slammed the move.
Wiggles music is created to bring joy and happiness to children and families. We are deeply disappointed to hear that it is being used in any other way.
But the council insists it's necessary.
It's near the bus shelter there. It's where some antisocial behaviour has happened in the past. It's a matter of trying to make sure we're deterring that congregation of people. So when our events are going on there, we're not having to go through and spend hundreds of thousands of dollars of repairing and maintaining the asset.
Every 2 months before Christmas, they start playing really loud music. It's sad. I think they really need somewhere to be able to go.
They play it over and over again, and it's not good.
The music has now been turned off, but it's not the first song that's been weaponised. Council coming under fire in 2017 for blasting this.
When my baby smiles at me, I go to Rio.
This is really an inhumane approach to responding to homelessness. And in fact, it doesn't really end the problem because it just moves it somewhere else.
Sadly, it's not just music or just this council. From spikes to bars to sprinklers, across the country, anti-homeless architecture is being used to keep vulnerable Aussies out of public spaces.
The problem is that the federal and state governments hold all the money and the mandate for homelessness. Often, local government turns to the only tool in their toolbox, and that's compliance. It's actually doing the things that will make people stay away or kicking people off the streets.
So is it time we stop targeting those with nowhere else to go?
It's comforting. It's blocked in. And this is where they can stay safe, you know, and sleep outdoors.
I hadn't thought about the fact that, yeah, the handrails on the benches is so that homeless people can't sleep.
It's
all quite subtle, but it is sinister and it isn't addressing a problem that's obviously there.
Yeah, I think part of the issue is that local councils who will then have to deal with their local constituents worrying about where the homeless people might be staying can't do anything about it because homeless shelters are run at a state and federal level. So
they don't have the funding to do it.
Yeah, it seems like such a strange way to go about it.
How do they not get that though? How do the local councils unlock that funding?
Well, yeah, exactly. That's it, right? And in the meantime, it just the means that they're going to try to rectify the problem seem like they're a strange way of going about it.
Yeah. Well, Bunbury Council's full statement is on our website.